Good morning. I'm Joe Collins, and welcome to Simi Church. Our mission is to love God and neighbor. We are a group of ordinary people who believe in the extraordinary message of Jesus Christ. So no matter who you are or what your story, we're glad you're here. You know, in just a minute, I'm going to say a prayer. But before I do that, I want to let you know that today is going to be a very special worship service. Instead of our traditional service, which mainly focuses on the preaching of God's word, today we're going to focus on everything else. That means we're going to focus on singing. We're going to focus on praying. We're going to focus on scripture reading. And of course, we're going to focus on a very special time of communion. I hope you enjoy. You know, Psalm 121 says this, "I lift up my eyes to the mountains. Where does my help come from? My help comes from the Lord, the maker of heaven and earth. He will not let your foot slip. He who watches over you will not slumber. Indeed, he who watches over Israel neither slumber nor sleep. The Lord watches over you. The Lord is your shade at your right hand. The sun will not harm you by day, nor the moon by night. The Lord will keep you from all harm. He will watch over your life. The Lord will watch over your coming and going, both now and forevermore." Let's open up our service today in a time of prayer. If you can at home, I want to encourage you to maybe go to your knees and join me as we pray. Father, I want to thank you so much for bringing us together this morning, especially for a very special time to just focus on our worship. Focus on our singing. Focus on our praying. Focus on the reading of scripture, and of course, on a time of communion. God, I want to thank you so very much that we have opportunities every week to turn our attention to you, to lift our eyes to you in praise, in worship, in gratitude, in thanksgiving. You truly are the maker of the heavens and the earth. And Father, we owe everything we are and everything we have to you. And I pray as we spend time today in this special worship service, I pray that we will be reminded of you. That it will be all about you today. That we will pour out our praise for the one who watches over us forevermore. It's in Jesus' name I pray. Amen.
Calling, Song we could ever sing, worthy of all the praise we could ever bring, worthy of every breath we could ever breathe. We live for you, all we live for you. Jesus, the name above every other. Jesus, the only one who could ever say, worthy of every breath we could ever breathe. We live for you, all we live for you. Holy, there is no one like you, there is none beside you. Open up my eyes. Show me who you are and fill me with your heart and lead me in your love to those around me. Jesus, the name above every other name. Jesus, the only all you could ever say, worthy, worthy of every breath we could ever breathe. We live for you, oh, we live for you. And we sing, holy, there is no one like you, there is none beside you. Open up my eyes in wonder. Show me who you are and fill me with your heart and lead me in your love to those around me. And I will give my life upon your love. It is a firm foundation. I will put my trust in you alone, and I will not be shaken. I will build my life upon your love. It is a firm foundation. show me who you are and fill me with your heart and lead me in your love to those around me.
Psalm 128. Blessed is everyone who fears the Lord, who walks in his ways. When you eat the labor of your hands, you shall be happy and it shall be well with you. Your wife shall be like a fruitful vine in the very heart of your house, your children like olive plants, all around your table. Behold, thus shall the man be blessed who fears the Lord. The Lord bless you out of Zion. And may you see the good of Jerusalem all the days of your life. Yes, may you see your children's children. Peace be upon Israel. Let us pray. Our Heavenly Father, we would admit that your ways are sometimes a little confusing to us, but your ways are precious. Your ways are true. Your ways are amazing. We would ask, Father, that you would give us the wisdom and understanding that we need to follow your ways at all times. Though we may not always understand why certain things happen, give us the strength that we need to continue trusting in you. Fill us with love, joy, and that peace that we so desperately need. Peace with each other. Peace among the world, peace with you. A peace that can only come on the grounds of the blood that was shed by your Son on the cross of Calvary. We would pray, Father, for your continued guidance and blessing. And we ask that you would help us to always reflect that light, love, and character of your Son to all of those around us. That we may live lives that will honor and glorify you. We pray these things in Jesus' name. Amen.
Somebody is hungry, somebody's in pain, somebody seems alone and fear, somebody's in shame, somebody needs a friend to lean on, somebody's not there, somebody's looking at the end, somebody's in prayer, praying,
Father,
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 Psalm 126. When the Lord restored the fortunes of Zion, we were like those who dreamed. Our mouths were filled with laughter, our tongues with songs of joy. Then it was said among the nations, the Lord has done great things for them. The Lord has done great things for us, and we were filled with joy. Restore our fortunes, Lord, like streams in the Negev. Those who sow with tears will reap with songs of joy. Those who go out weeping, carrying seeds to sow, will return with songs of joy, carrying sheaves with them. Now let's pray, and I'd like to use this psalm as a template for our prayer. Father God, you restore fortunes. Only you can restore us. And when you do, we can dream and we are inspired. Our mouths are filled with laughter, our tongues with songs of joy. God, you fill us with so much joy that we can't even believe, we can't even understand what that's like. All we can do is be joyful. You have done great things among us. You will do great things among us. And again, all we can do is be filled with joy at what you are capable of doing. God, you restore fortunes. I can't even imagine what your fortunes are. They are so much more than anything this world has to offer. There is time for sorrow and weeping, but God, you restore us, you comfort us, you are with us through every trial. And again, we can be filled with joy out of the greatest times of sorrow. God, you want nothing but the best for us. You protect us. You have given your Son, your Spirit, and your Word to guide us and protect us, God. And we lift our praise to you, because there's nothing else we can do. Please accept our time of worship, and may it be pleasing to you. In your Son's name we pray. Amen.
Everyone needs compassion, love that's never failing. Let mercy fall on me. Everyone needs forgiveness, kindness of the Savior, the hope of nations. Savior, he can move the mountains. My God is mighty to save. He is mighty to save. Forever author of salvation. He rose and conquered the grave. Jesus conquered the grave. Me as you find me, all my fears and failures. Fill my life again. I give my life to follow everything I believe in. Now I surrender. I surrender. Savior, he can move the mountains. My God is mighty to save. He is mighty to save. Forever author of salvation. He rose and conquered the grave. Jesus conquered the grave. Savior, he can move the mountains. My God is mighty to save. He is mighty to save forever. Author of salvation. He rose and conquered the grave. Jesus conquered the grave. Shine your light and let the whole world see. We're singing for the glory of the risen King. Jesus, shine the light and let the whole world see. We're singing for the glory of the risen King. Savior, he can move the mountains. My God is mighty to save. He is mighty to save forever. Author of salvation. He rose and conquered the grave. Jesus conquered the grave. Savior, he can move the mountains. My God is mighty to save. He is mighty to save forever. Author of salvation. He rose and conquered the grave. Jesus conquered the grave. Shine your light and let the whole world see. We're singing for the glory of the risen King. Jesus, shine your light and let the whole world see. We're singing for the glory of the risen King. Jesus, shine your light and let the whole world see. We're singing for the glory of the risen King. Jesus, shine your light and let the whole world see. We're singing for the glory of the risen King. Jesus, shine your light and let the whole world see. We're singing for the glory of the risen King. Jesus, shine your light and let the whole world see. We're singing for the glory of the risen King.
Hello, I'm Daniel Contreras, and once again, welcome to Simi Church. At this time, we're going to take communion and pray for the weekly offering. All you need is some matzah and grape juice. But before we do that, I'd like for us to take a look at a few verses in the book of Isaiah. We'll be looking at Isaiah chapter 52, verses 13 through 15. Now, this section forms the intro for the fourth and final servant song that's found in this book, and the emphasis in this song is on the suffering servant. All throughout the song, we see pictures of the Lord Jesus Christ. As I mentioned, the last three verses in chapter 52 serve as like the introduction to the song. It starts by talking about how prosperous the servant of the Lord will be. It says, "Behold, my servant shall deal prudently." In other words, he'll prosper and have success. "He shall be exalted and extolled and be very high." Exalted, extolled, and very high. These are three expressions that almost mean the same thing, but when we look at them more closely, we can see that they are referring to three separate events concerning this servant. Exalted here can be translated to be raised. Extolled can be translated lifted up or carried away. And the expression be very high denotes being lofty, reaching new heights and soaring far above anything else. Here we have a reference to the resurrection, ascension, and glorification of the Lord Jesus. In the Bible, we read that he was raised from the dead on the third day. We read that after he was resurrected, he was blessing his disciples and was parted from them and carried up into heaven. He ascended on high. And we read that he is now seated in glory at the right hand of God. He is exalted, extolled, and very high. But all of this would come at a very high cost. The prophet Isaiah gives us a small glimpse here of the journey that this servant would have to go through before these things would take place. Many were astonished at him, for his visage was marred more than any man, and his form more than the sons of men. Many would be appalled at the sight of Jesus. They would be stunned, devastated, and horrified. Why? Because his appearance would be so disfigured, so mutilated, so deformed that he would no longer look like the sons of men. He would no longer look human. Have you guys ever stopped to just think about that and meditate on that? How much force, how much trauma, how much punishment does a human body have to go through before it becomes almost unrecognizable? And what really breaks my heart when meditating on this is the fact that the Lord Jesus didn't even have to go through this. He didn't have to suffer. His body didn't have to be beaten and marred. God would have been perfectly fair in letting us suffer the consequences for our own sin. But you see, Jesus loves us so much that he willingly chose to endure all of that so that we may be saved, forgiven of our sin, and reconciled to God. Now, Isaiah goes on to say that just how the sight of Jesus would affect many people in the crowd, so would his sacrifice affect many people in the world. So shall he sprinkle many nations. There's a sense of sacrificial cleansing and spiritual purification here. Kings shall shut their mouths because of him. Everyone will marvel and be left speechless. For what had not been told them, they shall see, and what they had not heard, they shall consider. Now, there are a few different interpretations as to who was being referred to here, but, you know, I'd like to think that maybe it could be referring to those of us that have been saved. We will be left speechless. We will be amazed and left in awe because we have the privilege and opportunity of seeing and understanding things that we could have never otherwise comprehended apart from God. You know, in 1 Corinthians chapter 2, Paul expands on this idea and tells us how it is that we will get to see and understand these things. And he actually quotes from a later portion of Isaiah. In 1 Corinthians chapter 2, verses 9 through 12, he says this, "But as it is written, eye has not seen, nor ear heard, nor have entered into the heart of man the things which God has prepared for those who love him. But God has revealed them to us through his Spirit. For the Spirit searches all things, yes, the deep things of God. For what man knows the things of a man except the spirit of the man which is in him? Even so, no one knows the things of God except the Spirit of God. Now we have received not the spirit of the world, but the Spirit who is from God, that we might know the things that have been freely given to us by God." You see, thanks to Jesus' sacrifice, those of us who have put our faith and trust in him have been sealed with God's Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit dwells within us. And it is through him that God leaves us amazed and speechless by revealing all kinds of new mysteries every day, the deep things of God. Now, I'll leave you with this final thought. All of us, right now, ought to ask ourselves, am I one of these people that has been affected by the sacrifice of Jesus? Have I put my faith and trust in him? Have I been washed in the soul-cleansing blood of the Lamb and made pure by it? Have I accepted his gift of salvation? If you answered yes, then great. Praise God. Continue growing in your faith. But if you answered no, then I would say to you the same thing the Apostle Paul says to us. In 2 Corinthians 6:2, he says, "Behold, now is the accepted time. Now is the day of salvation. Don't wait any longer. Make the decision while you still can, before it's too late. Experience for yourself the love of God. Come and be amazed at all that he has in store for you. Jesus' sacrifice is enough. It is powerful enough to reach to every ends of the earth and sprinkle many nations, to cover even the vilest sinner like myself, to completely satisfy God's judgment for yours and my sin. He was beaten and marred and disfigured for it, but he was also exalted, extolled, and is now seated at the right hand of the throne of the majesty on high. May we lift them up today in praise and worship as we meditate on these things. May we give him the respect, honor, and glory that he richly deserves for all that he is and for all that he's accomplished for us." Now, at Simi Church, we believe the Bible is the best source of truth in our world today. In it, we learn that Jesus is Lord. He lived a sinless life, died on the cross, and rose to life again. And it's in this belief that we do everything. We're a member-supported fellowship by people like me. You can give today by texting keyword SIMI CHURCH to 77977 or online at simi.church. After I pray, we'll allow you some time to eat the bread and drink the cup in remembrance of Jesus and to meditate on his life, death, and resurrection. Let's go to God in prayer. Our Heavenly Father, we just want to thank you today for your Son, our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. We thank you, Father, that he would willingly come into this world. He would willingly make himself a part of his own creation, and that he would allow himself to be physically tortured by the very hands that he created, that he would shed his blood to cleanse us from all sin. And Father, as we meditate on these few verses, we can't help but to just be in awe of his great love for us. We pray, Father, that as we eat this bread and drink this cup, that you help us to see that body that was beaten and marred. Help us to see that blood that was shed so that we may partake of these emblems with grateful and thankful hearts. I pray, Father, that you can humble each and every single one of us, that we may make that life-changing decision to become followers and disciples of Christ if that hasn't happened yet, or that perhaps we can recommit our lives to him if we've strayed away. We praise him, Father, and we lift him up to you, thanking you for all that he is, for all that he's accomplished by way of the cross of Calvary, and for all that you offer through him. In his precious name we pray. Amen. I
I really hope you enjoyed today's worship service. If you weren't able to take communion, I want to encourage you to do so later today. You know, at See Me Church, we want to be your church, your family's church, and your neighbor's church. To learn more, all you need to do is ask the person who told you about us, or you can go to our website and contact us directly. And don't forget to check out all of our social media outlets and subscribe to them. I also want to remind all the members of Simi Church to be praying for, investing in, and inviting to church your neighbors, your family, and your friends. And prepare yourself to be the best you can be for them and for God. Next week, we'll be right back here for another awesome time to worship God together. God bless, and have a great week.
I count on one thing, the same God that never fails will not fail me now. You won't fail me now in the waiting. The same God who's never late is working all things out. You're working all things out. Yes, I will lift you high in the lowest valley. Yes, I will bless your name. Oh, yes, I will sing for joy when my heart is heavy all my days. Oh, yes, I will. Same God that never fails will not fail me now. You won't fail me now in the waiting. The same God who's never late is working all things out. You're working all things out. Oh yes, I will lift you high in the lowest valley. To glorify. Yes, I